We'll start with this video first, so that we'll get acquainted with the ongoing system.
Mumbai is a city of dreams, commercial capital of India. Everyone in this city is thriving to excel in his work or business. MCGM is helping you to pursue your dreams with the initiative of ease of doing business. Welcome to MCGM's portal for construction permits, a single window system for submitting your applications to get construction permits welcomes you. All the information you will need to obtain construction permits, such as related links and circulars, is just a click away on MCGM's portal. Departmental help manual for fire, traffic, storm water drain, sewage, hydraulic engineering are available at one place. FAQs related to different departments also can be viewed at one place. We keep you updated on this portal about details and forms under new releases section. Dashboard showing real-time statistics, your search to know current status of proposals, online payment, consultant search, registration of developers and consultant, along with help manuals are also easily accessible. Fee calculator is available on portal for automatic calculation of various scrutiny fees and charges. After successful login, the applicant lands on his console and can see the MIS report of all the submitted proposals. Proposal-wise status of each process is also available. This gives clear timeline for each process for every proposal. Click on New Application tab for fresh application, where you have 5 touch points available. You can apply for commencement, first CC, further CC, common completion request, and occupancy cum building completion certificate. For getting commencement, the applicant to select type of proposal such as building approval, layout, or miscellaneous proposal. Common application form, which consists of all the information related project, individual, different departments needs, has to be filled up. The plot can be located on GIS map or search by providing information such as ward, village. The information in DPGIS is synchronized with CAF. By selecting CDS number and clicking Verify Ownership tab. Property card mines from state government data. Documents related to your proposal can be attached with the proposal. NOCs related to sewerage, SWD, hydraulic engineering are generated automatically based on information provided via CAF. Online payment of scrutiny charges application is directly shared to all concerned departments such as CFO, Traffic, SWD, HE, CTSO, NMA, AAI, etc. Response from all the concerned departments is expected within 15 days. Then within 5 days, digitally signed IOD is issued, which can be downloaded from the console. Click on First CC tab and fill the necessary details. Within half a day, digitally signed First Commencement Certificate is issued, which can be downloaded through the console. Labor Department is also automatically intimated through the system. Under Process Number 5, Request for Plinth Verification and Further Commencement Certificate can be made through the console. Concerned Building Proposal Officials visit the site with prior communication through console, SMS, and email. Digitally signed copy of further CC can be downloaded from the console within 7 days from application. Under Common Completion Request Form, Process Number 6, after completion of all construction work, request for completion certificate can be made from console to all concerned departments from whom completion is mandatory. On receipt of common completion request from all the departments, the system provides specific date and time for joint site inspection. This is communicated by console, SMS, and email communication to all those who are concerned. After joint inspection, all the concerned departments submit their response through their console within 15 days of the application of the Common Completion Request Form. Application can be made through console for getting occupation cum building completion certificate tab under process number 7. On receipt of the request, concerned building proposal officials visit the site with prior communication through all defined communication channels. After site visit, digitally signed occupation cum building completion certificate is issued within 7 days from receipt of request. At MCGM, we are ensuring that those 8 processes of construction permits is completed in just 45 days. We understand your dreams and their importance. So we are providing you an environment which will make doing your business easier.
Go through the presentation. The best activity we have started to improve the capacity of all officials, because earlier we were used to have interaction within the zone only. So now this attempt we have made to have interaction with the entire zone along with the individual zone activities. So today's topic is ease of doing business. Basically, ease of doing business means providing the easiness to the business. So create business in the businesses are going on at each businesses. Especially we are standardizing the procedures by which we provide the approvals. It's a requirement, because by providing such a easiness, all sectorial development could happen at large. Practices are being implemented in all the countries in the globe. The practices ongoing and the business regulations, those are reviewed and ranked by the World Bank. So, 190 countries, such activities are taken by the World Bank, and the prospective investors from all over the globe can ranking system, and accordingly they invest in that country. So as far as the investment point of view is concerned, we are very much concerned. Ranking, World Bank ranks on the some cities in that country depending upon the population. In our country, this population is more. So Delhi and Mumbai, these are the two cities where different parameters are reviewed in that city only. World Bank ranks on 10 different topics, such as starting of business, dealing with the construction permission, getting electricity, and all other parameters like minority property tax, getting across the border, etc. So 10 parameters on which the World Bank ranks. Each parameter, and each year they publicize their reports.
As far as our country is concerned, since 2014, we have improved a lot in entire parameters. In 2014, the rank was 134, whereas 2020 rank is 63. Basically, World Bank have a case study proposal under which the procedures, cost, quality of regulation and time required are reviewed by the World Bank team with all countries. The case study proposal is warehouse on the plot area 929 square meter and built up area 1300.6 square meter, ground plus one floor structure, whose ownership is a private limited company, and those are sold in the market. If we go through the parameters, there are 4 parameters by which World Bank assess each country. World Bank assessment happens based on the 4 parameters, that is procedure, cost, quality of regulation and time required. Procedure and cost is our purview, since we are in executing authority, whereas quality and cost is a policy matter. Let us see how the procedures and time are defined. If some applicant comes for remark, he submit the application in prescribed format, that becomes a procedure number 1. When we issue a challan for the remark, it becomes procedure number 2. When the applicant goes to the citizen facility center and pay the necessary charges, that becomes procedure number 3. When he shows the receipt of the payment, so that becomes procedure number 4. And when we issue the remarks, that becomes procedure number 5. For getting a simple remark from any authority, it involves 5 procedures, and associated time, if we consider as a single day, so it becomes 5 days. If we use the technology in that, compile the all informations in one single application, the applicant apply online with the common application form, make the necessary payment and submit the application, immediately he will get the response. So this becomes a single procedure instead of five procedures. In the recent World Bank's ranking report, we observe that World Bank have mapped 19 procedures for construction, entire construction cycle, and associated time was 98 days.
Regards to the cost, World Bank have mapped 5.4%. Basically, this cost is depend on the value of the warehouse, and according to that value, it is a 5.4%, whereas our claim is 2.5%. As regards to the quality of regulation by which we issue the permissions, we have got 14 marks out of 15. And if we go on merit of each procedures, each parameters, as regards to the procedure, we got 44% marks, whereas time as 79.3% and cost as 72.9%. Ranking one person, one country have considered as 100% mark, then we are 72.4% marks we have got. So basically, construction permit is our parameter. And during, prior to the construction, pre-construction stage, construction stage, and post-construction stage, these are the three different ways where we issue the permissions. And accordingly, it's mapped by the World Bank. We have simplified the procedures. We have allocated the different resources and use the technology by which we are able to achieve the rank. Especially the construction-related procedures, we have minimized unwanted provisions, and the provisions which are not as per the regulations, those provisions we have eliminated. Technology, wherever possible, we have used in our system at all levels. We have provided the dashboards to all officials. We expect that each officials manage the dashboard and review the time schedule as defined by the notifications. Basically, World Bank reviews three methodologies. First, they assess the system. They access our portal, they access our web page, and whatever the documents we have uploaded in the system, and accordingly they take input from the officials. They review the system logs, they review the dashboards, they review the response issued by each of the officials. So these two points, those are available with us by which we can improve ourselves. We have 50% weightage, whereas other points, that is a contributor. So they interact with the contributors through the prescribed application form inputs. They also interact telephonically and in-person interaction. When they visit in our country, they visit to their offices and get input from there. Yes, system is required for improvement, and officials also maintain their logs. But with respect to other parameters, that contributors interaction and interaction with the informations to the contributors, this point is also need to be taken in very much in consideration. So we have to improve our system logs, and along with that, we have to interact with the contributors in detail. So if we go through each procedures which we have mapped and which World Bank have observed, so we says that submission of the application is the single process which will happen within half a day. But along with that, World Bank have mapped two different procedures, that is a property card and CPS map. So property card, we have integrated with the revenue department application, and the submission of the application, we have made the property card. Lot many times it happens that they issue a hard form property card also, and we, while scrutinizing the proposal, we observe that property cards are scanned and attached by the applicant. So last meeting with the settlement commissioner, we had an interaction when we briefed this about this practices. Accordingly, they notified that they have stopped the practices of issuing the hard form property card and also the CTS maps. So they have also notified that property cards and CTS maps are made available through different links of the revenue department. Along with that, they have integrated with the MCGM applications, and the applicant, prospective developers or architects who wants to that property card and CTS map, they can directly download from the system provided by them or integrated by the MCGM. So we can see by this way, we are able to eliminate these two procedures and we now a single procedure.
Further, procedure number two, we have defined for getting IOD. The World Bank have observed two extra procedures, that is obtaining no objection certificate from various agencies. Here we have mentioned that the moment applicant submit the application with all documents and payments directly goes to the all concerned departments including fire. The procedure number 5 they have added for hiring the licensed fire safety consultant to obtain the certification from the fire department. So here the case study proposal is of 929 square meter plot area and 13.6 square meter built up area. There is a notification from the fire department that if the structure for warehouse going to be constructed on 1000 square meter plot area and 1500 square meter built up area, there is no requirement of the fire NOC if it is to be used for storage of non-combustible material. In procedure number 5, applicant apply a single common application form for getting completion certificate from all the departments like stormwater drain, sewage, hydraulic engineering and fire department. A single common application form where the parameters required for getting the completion certificate is filled in a single application form, and the moment he submits the common application form, he gives SMS, email and console communication to all concerned. It is mandatory to all concerned departments who visit the site to upload their response within 24 hours. So by this way, different 5 procedures becomes a single procedure. In procedure number 8, World Bank again mapped 2 procedures, that is receiving final inspection from the building proposal office and obtain occupation cum building completion certificate. Here, obtain occupation from the building proposal department is no more required because from the system applicant download the building completion certificate. So there is no separate procedure for this. So it becomes single procedure. Our target is to achieve a single digit rank. So we require further more refinement in our procedures. Here we need to become a more optimistic regarding the each proposal, and whenever the rejection is required, we should quote a proper regulation and descriptive response so that the applicant will not be dissatisfied. Further, we should be acquainted with our system if we require the supports from experts, but we should not more dependent on that. Further, there is a need to have a regular interaction through the WhatsApp media, Facebook or mass communication. We should publicize the regular day-to-day training sessions or any improvements required on different media channels like YouTube. We should have regular meetings with the stakeholders, regular webinars with the all concerned. There need a grievance addressal system at each levels, not only to the deputy chief engineer level, but it also at executive engineer, assistant engineer and sub engineer, so that all can communicate, and if identified any issues, they can escalate to the higher authority and diffuse the grievances. Further, I would like to mention here that since we are a very transparent system, every approval, every remarks, every attachment, video clips and photographs are available on public portal. So all different departments, including World Bank peoples, including Government of India, government, state government, all officials are observing, including the citizens, your all responses. We must be very attentive and responsible while addressing our console and each proposals. Basically, the engineers we are working in this department are highly intelligent personalities while addressing the different issues. Our public interface is a very strong. Documents, photographs, video clips are available on the public domain. Our contributors are very strong. Those are getting the information from all resources. So we should be very vigilant and attentive, since our every activity is transparent. Act of individuals are observed not only within organization, but also other officials and auditors of the state and central government.